Kubernetes has become de facto orchestration tool, and initially it supported only stateless applications. The term stateless means that no data nor state is stored or needs to be persistent between pod restarts. Due to wide Kubernetes adoption, many teams decided to run not only stateless applications, but also migrate databases to Kubernetes. Kubernetes Stateful Set has four unique features to help run stateful applications. First of all, it's a stable, persistent storage. Stable in this context refers to persistence across pod rescheduling. Stateful Set allows you to mount a volume to the pod and persist data in that volume across pod restarts. Now, you can run stateful apps with deployment object as well. You can create a persistent volume claim, which is later consumed by a pod. If you have a default storage class or specified a storage class when creating PVC, persistent volume will be created automatically. PV holds information about physical storage, and PVC is just a request for PV. It works perfectly fine, but only if you don't want to scale your deployment. If you try, you will probably get an error that the volume is already in use when the pod starts on another node. With a stateful set, you can define volume claim template. It will automatically create a new PVC for each replica of the stateful set. If you set a replica to 10, you will get 10 volumes mounted to 10 pods. With a deployment, it still will refer to the same single volume across all the replicas. Next is a stable pod identity. With a regular deployment, you would create a service which will get a virtual IP address. To access your application, you would use that service endpoint. Traffic will usually be distributed randomly across all the pods. In stateful set, on the other hand, each pod gets a hostname derived from the stateful set name, index, plus a domain that consists of service name, namespace, and SVC cluster local. For example, if you deploy Postgres in the database namespace, you can access individual pod using Postgres 0.postgres.database.svc cluster local. Useful when Postgres 0 is a master and you want to access only Postgres 1, which is a read replica. Also, the headless service will create a DNS SRV record for you with a hostname and a port in case you want to use a client that supports CRV records. Next is a graceful deployment and scaling. When you create a deployment with n replicas, all the pods are immediately spun up. With stateful set, pods created one by one, starting from index 0. When a pod is created and it passes a health check, then a stateful set creates a second one, and so on. The same thing when you scale up a stateful set, it slowly adds one pod at a time. Sometimes you need to use stateful set but want all the pods deployed at the same time, similar to deployment. In that case, you can use pod management policy and set it to parallel. Finally, automated rolling updates. With default setting rolling update, it will proceed in the same order as pod termination, from the largest index to the smallest one, updating each pod at a time. Kubernetes control plane waits until updated pod is running and ready prior to updating its predecessor. If application doesn't require any stable identifiers or ordered deployment, deletion or scaling, you should deploy your application using deployment object. Thank you for watching. I've created a playlist if you like short videos like this.